guys, welcome to the channel. Today I have Mitz and his runes every 10 minutes. Someone else with this group password kills a boss, you will receive a 5% rune buff. Definitely worth it if you didn't. Now follow the path I take on my horse, you're going to see over Bloodstained. That won't be the best forever. The more that people know about it, the harder it will be to pull it off. I'll explain in a second. Now I found out about this from Danny Molina. I'll link his social down below. Now first off, you want to come to the first step, right where you started the game. When you spawn in, you want to turn around and head towards the cliff. Now follow the path I take on my horse, you're going to see all the bloodstains here, because obviously people are missing this jump up. It's not too difficult, just jump in this direction and then double jump to catch onto this ledge. And there are actually two places you can go. One is over here in this corner right there, and the other one is across. I'm just going to get a run up to show you. Right over here, there we go, thank god I made it. You could go around here and use this corner right here. So when you choose whichever one you want to use, this one is probably my favorite of the two. You're going to go and turn on your multiplayer by using the Fur Calling Finger Remedy. Now I usually use that to summon other people. All that does now is let you use the Taunter's Tongue, which will lure in invaders. If you don't have that, you just need to kill the invader in the round table hold. That is how you acquire it. I'll assume most of people already have it. Now another important thing is you want to make sure that your white cipher ring is turned on. That will bring in hunters, which is very, very important. And of course, turn off your blue cipher ring if you have that turned on. You don't want to accidentally be pulled out of your world during AF. If you don't have the white cipher ring, you can buy it.
It worked, but I didn't get along. Oh my lord, what if I said that I'm gay? You only get 1,000 for this each time. This is a lot slower. Thank you. God damn it, dude. God damn it. Why don't you miss me anymore? This method's better. Oops, wrong thing. I'll do that next time. I don't know why it didn't work that time. Thank you. Tedious work, ain't it? Ah, damn. Oh, he fell over. Almost. Wait, no. Okay, cool. Let's go. See, you can duplicate the remembrance. That's pretty cool if you ask me, Mudofuku. That's the only thing to this thing? What the hell? I'm sorry. Okay. Have a safe journey, ye tarnished. Let me fart in ye toilet. Man, I'm just so funny, honestly.
call unusual to this.
Have a safe journey, or fart in ye toilet. I need help. A lot of help.
You still have to put a bit of stats into endurance to equip colossal weapons and heavy armor at the same time. That is, if you want to maintain it in medium load. To get to this spot, I advise you to get the Third Church of America. From there, travel south and you will see Siofra River Well. Go down the well. It will...
Siofra River Well? No way. Third Church of America. America. Fuck yeah. Oh man, oh man, I swear women are strange. Become gay. Become what you papa always called you.
Think about approximately 1 minute. It's a very deep well. Once you are down, don't forget to get the grace point. Advance and follow the path in the video.
Don't forget to get the grace point. Damn it, I'm dying.
this spot right here, by the dead body, you will find the map. After riding the elevator... Follow the path once again. Spot right here by the dead body to find the map of the area. We have to make our way towards another elevator that would take you up. The enemies here might have a tendency to one-shot you, so be careful and get the grace points if you can. Once you have reached the elevator, put the two stone sword keys to activate.
Ha ha ha!
reach the elevator and put the two stone sword keys to activate it. Back at the surface, get the grace point. Go straight and be careful of the dangers ahead. Dodging the golems might be tricky. I would really advise that you kill the last golem before proceeding on how we proceed. Now,
will
give you the talisman if you kill the three invaders all in one go. You will notice the summoning points with the red tiles on the floor. You shouldn't die. Every time you die, it will reset again. How we are going to cheese this is to lure them into running over the ledge.
I don't see how them golems can see through this far.
And falling to their deaths. Watch the entire fight how I did it. We are going to cheese this is to lure them in. Notice the summoning points with the red tiles on the floor. You shouldn't die. Every time you die, it will reset again. How we are going to cheese this is to lure them into running over the ledge and falling to their deaths. Watch the entire fight.
Thank you.
how he would cheese it. Now, eating on how he would cheese it. Now, the jar will give you the talisman if you kill the three invaders all in one go. You will notice the summoning points with the red tiles on the floor.
How? What?
You shouldn't die. Every time you die, it will reset again. How we are going to cheese this is to lure them into running over the ledge and falling to their deaths. Watch the entire fight how I did it.
Bro, you're fucking joking, man. Yeah, of course. Oh, of course. And he can still shoot at me while this shit's fucking going on. I hate this shit, man. Thank you. Swear if it's that easy. There was never a fucking bear last time. What the fuck? That hits me? Oh my Alright then, just don't let me fucking do anything. Hits me. Finally, for fuck's sake. Oh, let's go, it works. Oh, my fucking heart. I'm showing my dad. I'm showing my, my. People, everybody bleed. Everybody needs some. Everybody love. Everybody know how it goes. Again. I hate this shit, man. Oh my God. I know that with the hot dog. No more rumbling.